वंदे गुजरात।
Students, how are you? I hope you all are fine and enjoying English class. Dear students, in the last episode, we began our class with activity 1A. We watched the role play between Ishita and the shopkeeper.
What do you want?
I want that paper. A pencil, a pen, a scissors, and a blue
button. How many card paper you want?
Two.
How many color pencils you want?
Three. Black, red, and yellow.
You want blue button? How many ml you want?
50 ml of blue button. How much is the bill?
80 rupees.
Here is the money. Here is the money. Here.
Since last class, we have been learning how to frame questions with how many and how much. Dear students, I am glad that you have already prepared 6 questions with their answers. Ane have varo che bija prashna banavano. But before that, let me recall how to frame questions with how many and with how much. Vadhuma apne countable nouns ane uncountable nouns vishe pan thodi mahiti medvishu. તોજ તો આપણે હાઉ મેની હાઉ મચ થી પ્રશ્ન બનાવી શકીશું. સો લેટ્સ વોચ ધ પીપીટી. લુક એટ ધ ફર્સ્ટ સ્લાઇડ. ઇટ ઇઝ અબાઉટ કાઉન્ટેબલ નાઉન્સ. કાઉન્ટેબલ નાઉન્સ આર ધ થિંગ્સ દેટ વી કેન કાઉન્ટ. લેટ સી સમ એક્ઝામ્પલ્સ. સી ધેર આર ગીવન સમ એક્ઝામ્પલ્સ. લેટ્સ રીડ ઇટ. ચેર, ટેબલ, બેગ, pencil, eraser. Let's read some more. clock, duster, paper, speaker, mic and picture. You have to read with me. Let's read. Ball, bat, pen, shirt, t-shirt, bicycle, scooter and book. These all nouns are countable. We can count all the things. So, these nouns are considered as countable nouns. Students, now we will have understanding about uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns are the things that we cannot count. What is it on the screen? It is milk. It is liquid. Can we count liquid? No, we cannot count any liquid. So, it is uncountable noun. We cannot say a milk or we cannot say milks. It is always in a singular form. Students, you must keep in mind that uncountable nouns are always in singular form. Now, let's frame questions with how many. We have to keep in mind that whenever we are framing question with how many, the noun is always countable and it is always in plural form. So, let's frame some questions. Bicycles. Are vidyarthiyo, tame to majama aavi gaya. I know you love riding bicycle. How many bicycles are there? Let's count. 1 and 2. So the answer is 2. Students, as we know, bicycle is countable noun. So, we have to frame question with how many. Let's read the question. How many bicycles are there? The answer is 2. Look on the screen. Here we are given uncountable noun. When we have to frame question with uncountable noun, we always use how much. And it is always in singular form. Let's see some uncountable nouns on the screen and frame some more questions. What is it? It is water. It is an uncountable noun. Can we count water? No, we cannot count water. So, we cannot use how many, we have to use how much. Let's frame the question. How much water is there in this bottle? And the answer is 1 liter. Let's go to the next slide. Students, whenever we talk about price or money, we make question with how much, because money and price both are uncountable nouns. Let's frame a question. How much is for this bottle? The answer is rupees 15. I hope after watching this presentation, you are able to frame questions with how many and how much. In the last episode, you did pair up and you completed 6 questions with the answers. Now, we have to frame 4 questions. Let's start framing question. So, students, open your textbook of English, Unit 5, Activity 1B, page number 53. We will frame questions and write down the answers. Students, as you already know, we have written up to 6 questions. Let's read clue number 7. What is given there? Shampoo, sachet, and rupees 3. How do we pronounce sachet? Repeat after me. It is called sachet. Very good. Now, let's frame a question. Here we are given shampoo. And shampoo is an uncountable noun. We know when there is an uncountable noun, we frame question with how much. How do we frame the question? Let's make it. Write down in your textbook how much shampoo is there in the sachet. Students, look in the clue. Are we given answer? No, but we are given the price. It is only rupees 3. જો 3 જ રૂપિયા હોય તો કેટલું શેમ્પૂ આવે? ફક્ત 1 ml કે 1.5 ml આવે? So let's write down the answer. 1.5 ml. Students, you can also write like this. There is 1.5 ml shampoo in the sachet. Here we are given the price of this sachet. And we know when the price is given, we frame the question with how much. Students, in clue 5, we have already prepared questions with how much. How much is for this packet? Similarly, in clue 7, we are given the price of sachet. The price is rupee 3. So, we'll frame the question with how much. Write down in your textbook. How much is for this sachet? Look in the clue. What is the answer? Oh, rupees 3. Write down. Now, let's read clue number 8. Here we are given 8 GB pen drive and the price is rupees 300. Vidyarthi mitro, thodo dhyan thi juo. Price no spelling khoto lage che ke nahi? Ha. To tyan z che, teni jagyaye c lakhi do. Chalo fatafat lak sudhari do. Very good. Now, here we are given the price of 8 GB pen drive. The price is always an uncountable noun. So, we'll frame question with how much. Write down how much is for these HGB pen drive. What will be the answer? Shodo. Yes, the answer is rupees 300. Write down in your textbook. Vidyarthi mitro, aaj prashna ne biji rite banavi shakai? Yes, of course. Chalo to biji rite aa prashna ne banavie. How much does 8 GB pen drive cost? Now write down in your textbook. How much does 8 GB pen drive cost? And the answer remains same. The answer will be ₹300. Very good. Students, let's take clue number 9. What are given here? Wheat, sack, 100 kilogram, and the price is 2400. Students, don't you think clue number 9 is very easy to frame question? Look at clue number 5. Here we are given questions with their answers. And we have to frame questions in clue 9 similarly. Vidyarthi Mitro, clue 5 ma jem prashna ane javab apela che. Te j rite apde clue 9 ma pan prashna ane tena javab banavana che. Ghanu j easy che. So chalo, pair work karo ane prashna banao tatha tena javab lakho. I am giving you some time. Students, now let's check your answer. I hope you all have prepared questions and their answers correctly. Very good. Let's read the question. How much wheat is there in the sack? The answer is 100 kilogram. What will be the next question? How much is for this sack? The answer is ₹2400. Now the last clue. Here we are given iPod, memory and 4 GB. We know memory is an uncountable noun. Can we count memory? No. So let's frame a question with how much. Students, write down how much memory is there in the iPod. What will be the answer? Yes, the answer is 4 GB. Now, we are not given the price, but I think now you are able to ask questions to know the price. Let's frame our questions to know the price of iPod. Are you ready? Let's write down. How much is for these iPod? Vicharo, shu javab aavse? Javab to aapyo nathi. Shu aavi shake? 4 GB nu iPod che. Barabar. We'll write down the answer ₹250. So students, we read all the 10 clues and then we frame questions and answers. Now I hope you are able to frame questions with how much and with how many. Even you can frame questions to know the price. So students, now let's move towards the activity number 1C. There is one beautiful advertisement. We have to read the advertisement. Then there are given some questions based on the advertisement. Let's read out the advertisement and find out the answers. Are you ready? Students, let's read the advertisement. Put your pen on the text. Are you a music lover? Souls of Entertainment. Singer Aditya Nayak and Anjana Yagnik. Guitar Abhimanyu. Drum Munaf Patel. Flute Ninad. Shows Saturday and Sunday, 18th, 19th April, 10 a.m., 2 p.m., 8 p.m. Adults, rupees 250. Students, rupees 120. Students, I hope you must have understood that the advertisement is about music. And I know you are also lover of music. Are you a music lover? Yes. We all are music lovers. What is the theme written here? The theme is Souls of Entertainment. Who are the singers? Read out. Kon kon che singer? Aditya Nayak ane Anjana Yagnik. There are given some musical instruments. It is about a musical show. So, there must be some musical instruments. Let's underline the instruments. First is guitar. Second is drum. Chalo, triju kya che? Shodhi kado. Very good. Kayu che? Flute. Saras. Have a instruments ne vagadnar musician pan joishu ne. Chalo read out karishu. Who are the musicians? Abhimanyu will play guitar. Munaf Patel will play drum. And Ninad will play flute. Students, jo tamare show java javu che, to time અને તારીખ પણ ખબર હોવી જોઈએ ને. ચાલો તો ક્યારે જોવા જવાનું છે. લેટ્સ ફાઇન્ડ આઉટ વિચ આર ધ ડેઝ. સેટરડે એન્ડ સન્ડે. એન્ડ વિચ આર ધ ડેટ્સ. કઈ ડેટ આપેલી છે? 18th એપ્રિલ અને 19th એપ્રિલ. વિદ્યાર્થી મિત્રો, આપણને ટાઈમિંગ પણ ખબર હોવો જોઈએ, કેટલા શો છે અને ક્યારે ક્યારે છે. જો ફર્સ્ટ શો કેટલા વાગે છે? 10 AM. સેકન્ડ શો 2 PM. ધ થર્ડ શો 8 PM. વેરી ગુડ. સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ, કેન વી ગો ફોર અ મ્યુઝિક શો વિધાઉટ ટિકિટ્સ? નો, we can't go. We have to pay for tickets. And the rates of tickets are different. Let's read out there. Adults have to pay rupees 250. And students have to pay rupees 120. Do you know the meaning of adult? Adult kone kaishu apde? Adult એટલે એવા લોકો જેમની ઉંમર 18 વર્ષથી ઉપર હોય. વિદ્યાર્થી મિત્રો, તમે એડલ્ટમાં આવશો? નો, યુ કેન નોટ બી કાઉન્ટેડ એઝ એડલ્ટ્સ. ચાલો થોડા પ્રશ્નો આપ્યા છે તેના જવાબ આપણે લખી લઈએ. સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ, નાવ It's time to find out the answers from advertisement. Open page number 54, activity 1D. Here we are given 7 questions. Let's read out the first question. On which day can you go for the music concert? Read the advertisement. Where are the days? Okay. There are given 2 days. Which are they? Saturday and Sunday. So, we can go for music show on Saturday and Sunday. Let's write down the answer. Vidyarthi Mitro, અહીંયા યુથી પ્રશ્ન પૂછ્યો છે માટે આપણે જવાબની શરૂઆત આઈ થી કરીશું. લેટ્સ સ્ટાર્ટ. આઈ કેન ગો ફોર ધ મ્યુઝિક કોન્સર્ટ ઓન Saturday and Sunday. Now, let's read the second question. It is a very easy question. Let's read it out. How many shows are there? Look in the advertisement. Here we are given 10 a.m., 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. It means there will be 3 shows. So, write down the answer. The answer is there are 3 shows. Very good. Now, we'll read the third question. How much will your mother pay for the music concert? Vidyarthi Mitro, tamara mummy adult ma avse ne? સાચી વાત. તો તેમણે કેટલા રૂપિયા ચૂકવવા પડશે? વેરી ગુડ. વોટ વિલ બી ધ આન્સર? ધ આન્સર ઇઝ રૂપીઝ 250. અહીંયા તમને યોર મધર કીધું છે. સો વિલ સ્ટાર્ટ અવર આન્સર વિથ માય મધર. રાઇટ ડાઉન માય મધર will pay rupees 250 for the music concert. હવે જુઓ એના જેવો જ નીચેનો પ્રશ્ન છે અને ઈઝી છે. આવડશે ને? હાઉ મચ વિલ અ ક્લાસ એ સ્ટુડન્ટ પે ફોર ધ શો? લુક ઇન ટુ ધ એડવર્ટાઇઝમેન્ટ એન્ડ સી હાઉ મચ અ ક્લાસ એ સ્ટુડન્ટ હેઝ ટુ પે. યસ, વેરી ગુડ. ધ આન્સર ઇઝ 120. લેટ્સ રાઇટ ડાઉન ધ આન્સર. A class a student will pay rupees 120 for the show. Students, the last questions are very easy. Now, it's your turn to find out the answers. So, read the advertisement walk in pair, and write down the answers. Dear students, I hope you have written all the three answers. The answers are very easy, and I hope you have written correctly. Let's check out your answers. Let's read the question number 5. How many singers are there? The answer is, there are 2 singers. Very good. Let's read question number 6. Who are the singers? What will be the answer? Yes, Aditya Nayak and Anjana Yagnik are the singers. Now the last question. Which instruments do the artist use? The answer is, the artist use guitar, drum and a flute. Dear students, so far we have learned how to frame questions with how many and how to frame questions with how much in activity 1B. We also had an advertisement in activity 1C. We wrote the answers of that advertisement in activity 1D. Now, I hope you all are able to frame questions with how many and with how much. Whenever you want to know price of a thing, then you have to frame a question with how much. Whenever you find a thing which is countable, then you frame a question with how many. And whenever you see a thing which is uncountable, then you frame a question with how much. I have enjoyed the lesson very much. I hope you also have enjoyed it. And I hope now you all will frame questions with how many and how much. So students, keep framing questions in English and also try to answer the questions in English and practice it well. See you afterwards. Bye-bye.